can't count the times I almost said what's on my mind, but I didn't. And just the other day, I wrote down all the things I'd say.
To my dearest Courtney and my best friend, who would have thought that 11 years ago we met for the first time as friends, and fast forward to now we're getting married and have a beautiful 7-month-old baby. Sorry for texting you that my name was Tucker when you first gave me your number. I was trying to be cool, but somehow it worked out because you're marrying me now. It's always hard for me to stay mad at you after an argument because you have some sort of power that makes me forget that I was mad about you. You have the biggest heart I know. You taught me how to love unconditionally. You have shown me how to be kind, even in difficult times. You're one of a kind, Courtney Suliana Angelique Marie Svahina Kokovalu, soon to be Mrs. Matoto. You're the one I dream about all day. You're the one I think about all day. Thank you for knowing the way to my heart and through my stomach. In all seriousness, I'm the luckiest guy in the universe, and we're a match made in heaven. I can't wait to see you walk down the aisle in your beautiful dress and see your gorgeous smile. Here's to the first day of the rest of our lives together, my love.
Love is more than words. It is more than a sentence on this piece of paper. And my love for you, Sione, is more than love. It is higher than the tallest mountain and deeper than the ocean seas. My Sione, this is more than just a love letter. I promise to always, always try to experience new and exciting things together, to never stop impressing you, to always be faithful to you, to keep having your babies, and to always be there for you. I promise to inspire you as you have inspired me, to support all your goals and aspirations, to lift you up when you're down, to kiss your cheeks when you need me to clean your mess up when you spew. Together we are better than we could ever hope to be alone.
That second glass of wine that did it. There was something about that kiss, girl, it did me in. Got me thinking, I'm thinking.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Courtney, take you, Sione, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I would be lying if I said that I live this life without you.
I never told my sister, but I did always catch her when she was kind of sneaking out the house.
She did the old, no. She did the old sneaky, don't turn on the engine, but take off the handbrake and push the car down the driveway. And although sneaky, I think me and Nao picked up on her ways and did catch her a few times. I guess the meaning of these short but very brief stories was that their love was very imperfect but also perfect. I've made so many memories with you over this lifetime, and there's no way in this lifetime, in the next lifetime, that I would ever not have you as my best friend. And to Sione, there's no way in this lifetime, in the next lifetime as well, that I'll never not have you as my sister's partner and soulmate.
I'm so happy for the both of you. I've never seen Sione Tupo much happier. Sione Tupo has always been my best friend and brother. We grew up doing everything together. We've also been roommates. And now that he's found someone to share his life with, Sione Tupo has always been my right-hand man throughout the biggest moments of my life. And I can't wait to be able to watch everything unfold for the two of you.
So Sione, I couldn't be much happier than I am today to know on that from now on, Courtney can count on you. The way she looks at you reminds me of how her mom used to look at me some moons ago. You are now, Sione, her protector, her best friend, and from today on, you won't be my son-in-law, but my son. You are one of my boys. And that is wealth, and no man can ask for more than that.
You wanna know?